Yeah. Drive, Jason. Where you meet that man?
Oh.
You gotta get some old body. You gotta be aggressive. It'll pay off in the long run, guys. Go to the middle.
All
Put deep in.
Get it.
Follow it.
Get it.
Just hold your position, Justin. He'll charge you.
No. It can't be 1-1. This is starting of a new half. This is starting. Huh? Yes, that's not 1-1. There's no way. They've had 7 fouls?
The coach, they're going to get expelled.
Look! 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 Look!
stop dribbling because that'll kill you every time you do it. Well, we don't want to.
Be aggressive, Jimmy! Pause, Jesus. With the Wake Forest Demon Deacons with a last minute run have stretched the lead to 41-32, ironically their biggest lead of the ball game. And I think for the Seawolves, they're gonna have to do something about containing Trelawney Owens. 19 points in the first half, and they got a little bit sloppy at the end of the first half. They needed to keep contact.
Well, they have to play better defense, Barry. Don't let the ball get inside the gut like that, and also continue to shoot the basketball. They shot 32% for the first half. The ball will go into the basket, but you got to stay after it.
And it wasn't just that the fact that Alaska Anchorage lost a little concentration at the end. When they did lose concentration, Wake made them pay.
Oh, indeed, they did. Wake just continued to apply pressure using their experience right as the half ended within the last 2 minutes, made some key steals, got the ball in their hands, and when they did, went down and attacked the basket.
Harrison, one of the keys for them, but Owens was really the guy who did the damage. 19 points, he got him underneath as he did here, or that was Banks with the basket, but Owens got him down low, he got him up top. They shot 50% in the first half, 24 rebounds, a slight rebounding edge. Alaska Anchorage did have a lot of second chances, but look at the shooting percentage for Alaska Anchorage. Not so good.
Shooting percentage and free throws. Wake got to the free throw line 10 times. Alaska Anchorage only got there twice.
So the Seawolves will start things here in the second half.
I think if the Seawolves just continue to work the basketball around, spread the floor a little bit, which is what they're doing, work to get the shots, and as they get the shot, continue to go to the board.
Same starting lineups that opened the ball game for both teams, Childress, Harrison, Lucas, Owens, and Duncan for Wake Forest. For Alaska Anchorage, Kaiser and Reiser, much to my chagrin, Samuel, Fox, and Anderson.
One of the things I think a lot of young kids really get excited about. Nice pass inside and a very good look. Raymond Samuels able to get that ball off, but one of the things young kids get excited about is getting their shot blocked. And it looks like Alaska Anchorage is so afraid of getting their shot blocked, they're putting the ball back up on the board too quickly. Quick head fake will get them to the free throw line so they can improve on those numbers.
Creators of Neon, proud sponsors of our 1994 U.S. Olympic team.
Magic Johnson, Steve Jones, Dick Enver back in Minneapolis. Scottie Pippen with his last delicate finger roll for 27 points. He's four under his season high of 31. 32 years ago in St. Louis, Philadelphia's Wilt Chamberlain established the All-Star record. He scored 42 points. He also had 24 rebounds, but all in defeat as the West would win the game 150 to 130. And Pippen at 27 at least could flirt with a possible All-Star record.
Not only does he have 27 points, but he has 10 rebounds. I mean, and I don't know how many deflections and steals, but like Steve Jones was saying, he's been all over the basketball court making things happen.
Mark Price out to Dominique Wilkins. He's off the mark, and David Robinson has it for the West. The West trailing by six on the attack. Danny Manning. Horace Grant with the rebound. rebound, and it's B.J. Armstrong.
With this group that is out on the floor for the East, Mark Price really has to make things happen. And if he doesn't, the West has a chance to close on the lead.
Mark Price, what a sharpshooter. 13 for him.
Man, you've been right on the money all evening.